Let's move ahead to the next video from ASP.NET Authentication and Authorization video series. In our previous video, we had discussed about the four important vocabularies, that is authentication, authorization, principal, and identity objects. What we'll do is, in this video, we'll first try to understand what are the different ways of doing authentication and authorization in ASP.NET, and then we'll look into, in depth of how to do Windows authentication. Now, in ASP.NET, there are three primary ways by which you can do authentication and authorization. The first one is the Windows authentication, second is forms authentication, and the final one is the passport authentication. In Windows authentication, the ASP.NET pages will use the local Windows users and groups to authenticate and authorize resources. So in other words, if you remember in the previous video, we have shown the user Shiv, and we were trying to use the Shiv and administrator which were created in the Windows Active Directory services. So basically in this methodology, in the Windows authentication methodology, the ASP.NET web pages will use the local user groups to authenticate and authorize resources. Forms-based authentication is nothing but the cookie-based authentication. Here the username and password are stored into the client machines as cookie files. In case the browser doesn't support cookies, then these user ID and passwords are passed via the URL string for every request. Now in forms-based authentication, what you can do is basically you can create your own screen with your own login screen and password and a button. And basically at the behind code, you can write your logic, for authenticating and authorizing. And the cookie creation part of it, comes as a part of forms authentication. So basically once the authentication is done by whatever means it is, either from SQL server or either from the web config file, this cookie file is stored to the client machine. And later on, rather than authenticating, authorizing again and again, the cookie file is taken as a reference to check if the user has proper credentials or not. The final type of authentication is a passport authentication. Now many times what happens is basically rather than having the user ID and password or the usernames stored into your web application, you'd like to validate usernames which are coming from Hotmail or which are coming from Windows Live. In other words, which are coming from Microsoft sites, Microsoft password driven sites. So in other words, you'd like to validate if the user is present in the Hotmail or in the Windows Live or connect.com, whatever it is. And later on, once the authentication has successfully happened in those databases, then those user can come and browse your site. Especially, if you're building up a site which is, like a e-commerce site, where you just want to ensure that the user has a valid Hotmail account, then probably you can use passport authentication. And final one is anonymous access, where you do not want any kind of authentication to be supported. So in other words, there are three kinds of authentication you can do in ASP.NET: Windows, Forms, and Passport. Now what we'll do in this session is we will look into in depth of how can we implement Windows authentication. So in the coming up what we'll do is we will create a simple project and we'll create users into the Windows account, into the Windows users and groups account, and we'll see that how we can do authentication and authorization using Windows authentication. In order to demonstrate Windows authentication, what we'll do is we'll create three pages here, something like this: admin.aspx, home.aspx, and user.aspx. And what we'll do is basically the admin.aspx can be accessed by only administrators. So we'll create two users in our computer management. We will create one is Shiv and the other one is the administrator. Now the administrator has access to both the pages. In other words, he has access to admin.aspx as well as to the user.aspx. But the Shiv user has only access to the user.aspx. So the time he goes to browse admin.aspx page, he won't be able to do that. So what I've done is, in order to do this, I have created here the users. So you can see that this is my computer management, my local user groups, and I have created one user here called as administrator, and this is basically member of administrator group. And I have created one user which is a simple user, that is Shiv, which is member of just users. Okay, now let's go back to our ASP.NET page, because now that we have set up the users, let's go to the ASP.NET page and see that what kind of configurations we need to do on the ASP.NET application side. So you can see the first thing what I've done here is I've created my three pages here: admin.aspx, home.aspx, and user.aspx. I'm going to say those pages have nothing as such, just a small title. For example, if it's admin page, I'm just saying this is admin.aspx page. If it's a home page, it has link to the simple user page and to the admin page. And in the user.aspx, again, there is a simple text here saying this is a simple user page. Now the first thing what we need to do is we need to go and say that we are going to use Windows authentication. So go to the web config file of your project, and over there in the authentication tag, in the mode, say that we need to basically use the Windows authentication. And the second point, what we need to do is we need to say that we want to deny any kind of users who are anonymous. So anybody who comes without a username and password, we want to just deny it. So what we have done is we have put up an authorization tag here, and we are saying that deny any kind of users who are unknown. So now that at the top level we have defined that we are going to use Windows authentication, and any anonymous user, you know, will not be allowed to access this website. Now we also need to provide the second level of access, stating that basically for the admin pages only administrators have access. So in other words, if Shiv goes and tries to access the admin pages, he will get an error. So in order to do that, what you have to do is you have to use the locations tag. So in the locations tag, you can see that I have specified here admin.aspx, and I'm saying that I'm specifying the authorization rule, saying that any user who is, you know, who is not administrator, in other words, only administrators are allowed to browse this page. So basically we have specified here stating that for admin.aspx, only administrators will be allowed to browse the pages. Now let's go and build this website, and let's deploy this website on IIS, and let's see that how it looks. So let us go and build this build solution, and let me just go and publish this site. So I published the site, saying yes, replace all. Let's go to the IIS, and this is my web application to which this directory has been mapped, right? And let's ensure that, you know, we have integrated Windows authentication checked here and the anonymous is disabled, and let's say okay. And you can see that so just refresh this, you can see that whatever we have compiled, the home.aspx pages, user.aspx page, and the admin.aspx page here. Now let's go and browse the home.aspx page. So it pops up a box here, you can see. Now what we'll do is first let's go and put administrator. So let me log in as administrator. Administrator and my password. So because this is a valid user, he will allow me to access the home.aspx page. And because this is an administrator who is logged in currently, you know, I will be able to go and browse to the simple page, and also I'll be able to browse to the admin pages. Now what I'll do is let me go and close this browser, and again I'll let me go and browse this page, and this time I'll log in as the simple user, that is Shiv. So let me just put Shiv here and Shiv. Now if you remember, one of the things what we have done in the webconfig file is that we have said that simple users cannot access administrative pages. So I'm able to see the home page, but you know, if I click on the administration page, the admin.aspx page, you know, it's throwing me again the box. And in case I don't put a proper user ID and password, it just throws me error. But at the same time, if I go to the simple user page.aspx, I'm able to browse. So you can see that basically Shiv is a simple user, so he is only able to browse the simple user page, that is user.aspx, while the administrator was able to browse all the pages of the website. Now that's all about Windows authentication. Now in the next session, what we'll do is we'll try to understand three important concepts: digest, basic, and integrated. When we configure the Windows authentication, you must have noticed that I had only checked the first checkbox. But if you go to your internet information server, there are other two checkboxes also associated. One is the digest and basic. So let's first try to understand what these three checkboxes are and how they differ. And then what we'll do is, you know, in the next coming up session, we'll concentrate on forms authentication, we'll concentrate on ASP.NET, you know, users and roles, and etc. So I hope that you are enjoying this session, and see you in the coming up videos.